Well, here's another topic. Here's something else to talk about. Okay, so let's talk about Seagate's 10 terabyte hard drive.
All right, something that matters.
Tell us about it. I know some specs and stats and prices here, but I'll let you get into it.
Brand new 10. This is the world's largest consumer hard drive. And you got to use the word consumer because 10 terabyte hard drives have been out for about a year, maybe a year and a half already. Those are enterprise grade drives for servers, also pretty damn expensive. This drive, the whole idea is like, hey, this is aimed for desktop. We've made it a performance drive, 7,200 RPM, 256 megs of cache, 200 meg sequential read write. It's actually pretty good. And it's a list price of $534. And so it's probably going to street, honestly, once the initial demand kind of dies off, I would think, you know, high fours, right? So it's not bad. And, you know, the previous largest consumer drive was like really, I think, 6 to 8 terabytes, 8 terabytes maybe. So
what's the cost per gigabyte or terabyte?
I have that.
That versus.
You got it? I got it too.
Those 6 or 8 terabytes.
Right. So I've got little charts.
So it's. I'll just answer the first part, and then Gordon can take it. So it's 37 cents a gigabyte.
Yeah.
Okay.
No, I'm sorry. For it's five. SSD. That's for Samsung's. Sorry about that. It's 5 cents a gigabyte.
Right. 37 cents a gigabyte is for the world's largest SSD, which is Samsung's 850 Evo. 4 terabytes, $1,500. Right. So that's 37 cents a gig. The 10 terabyte Barracuda Pro, which is their Barracuda name returns, is 5 cents a gigabyte, which... I was actually crunching the numbers. Just these are really rough numbers, but it's not bad. So the best drives right now are 2 terabyte drives, 4 terabyte, kind of 6 terabyte, and there is one lower performance 8 terabyte drive. Those are about 3 cents a gig.
Okay.
So this 5 cents a gig is the equivalent of a 1 terabyte hard drive. So if you actually are buying a 1 terabyte hard drive, you're paying 5 cents a gig. You're kind of getting kind of screwed there. So.
Yeah.
And there are some performance drives that cost more. So the price is somewhat reasonable. So if you look at like the enterprise, these helium filled drives, this drive is not helium filled. Those drives are 6 cents and Hitachi's is 8 cents a gig.
So who's going to buy this?
The person who's going to buy this is somebody who has a machine that you can only put one hard drive in. So small form factors, micro towers. You put one drive in for your, you know, for if you have a home theater PC and you're recording video to it. There are people who still do that. That's a good place for it. People who just basically need more storage, you know. Honestly, I think you never can have enough when it comes to storage, right? I have a 3 terabyte and a 4 terabyte hard drive, magnetic. I've got SSDs in the box too, but... it would be nice to put a 10 terabyte drive in and back up everything to that. So
yeah, it's good. Yeah, it's good backup. You can do multiple full drive backups to it. And then, of course, the people who the torrent freaks who just like to download all the movies in the world and just fill up a drive and just to have them, never watch them, just get all the everything in the world. You know, they'll buy that.
There's something about having that much data on in a single enclosure that sort of scares me a little bit.
Everybody yeah. else, there's always that, like, there's always somebody who says that every time.
Why buy one?
Well, you got the 1 gigabyte. If I lose that drive, I lose everything. Yeah, I do understand. But
so you need two, and then you need the like mirrored rig.
You need two, or if this, I mean... You know, I think the crazy thing is this is a performance drive, right? So like performance and hard drive doesn't make any sense. It's like jumbo shrimp. It's still damn small, right?
Yeah.
So it's still slow. It's you know, the read write speed's not bad, sequential, but you get to random access. SSD is going to be all over this. I'll never move off of an SSD for a hard drive. It's like even if this were 20 terabytes, I would never boot to it. I'm going to boot to my SSD.
Right.
I want to back up everything to it.
Right.
So you sort of assume this is your backup drive primarily.
And media, things like, you know, video, audio, stuff like that. It's all played and it's all written and played sequentially and stuff anyway, you know, and it's plenty fast for that. So
yeah,
but, you know, unless you're doing 4K video editing, you know, then yeah, you can dump all those kind of things on a big drive.
Yeah. And I guess the argument of course is like, well, why would you buy this damn thing? It's $500 for 10 terabytes. I could buy, 3-4 terabyte drives for, you know, $200 a piece and I get 12 terabytes out of it. Right. Mm-hmm. But then you got 3 drives. If one of those fails, the argument is you only lose a third of your data, The other argument is like, you got three drives, you just tripled your chances of something dying.
Yeah, I remember, I'm right. having deja vu, I think literally like 15 years ago, we had this big argument about whether that was a valid argument. And there's right. some reader, this is at a different publication, there's some reader who is trying to convince us, like, you guys are wrong, the chances of failure do not go up, it's exactly the same. Did we ever resolve that?
I don't think we ever did. Because I do think you've got three drives, so, you know, all mechanical devices are a crapshoot, yeah. right? Mm-hmm. You have hard drives are like from 25 years ago that are still working, and you've got a hard drive you bought last week that takes a dump.
Yeah.
So you've got a crapshoot that random number generator rolls and one drive dies. Well, I think it increases the chances.
We should send an answer line to our new answer line yes. columnist and say, you know, get him to answer it. He'll do all the research for us so we don't have to.
That's sort of the math thing. Like yeah. the chance of each drive failing doesn't go up.
Right.
But the more drives you have, the chance of one drive failing does go up.
Yeah. Right.
I can't imagine if you had a server room full of 10,000 drives, your odds of one failing is the same as if you had one drive in one computer somewhere.
That's, yeah.
So, but yeah. yeah, I mean, you know, you're just having a 10 terabyte drive doesn't mean you don't have a backup. You always have to have a backup plan. Right. So, but if I can yep. consolidate, you know, two drives into one and still have space, and then, you know.
Do you guys know anyone who actually lives entirely on the cloud? I mean, it's probably not someone like us, but, you know, are there regular old mainstream civilians who just have all their photos and everything on the cloud?
No such thing.
I have, all of mine are also on the cloud. Uh-huh. I've got them on my thing, but on my computer, but any photo or any non-replaceable data, you know, important documents, stuff like that, all of that is on a cloud service, because if something just catastrophic failure, fire, whatever, some problem happens in my local, anything really important that I can't just replace, I'll get back.
But I bet there's some really young people out there who all their photos are shot with a phone. So that's automatically on the cloud through the device backup. And then they might just be streaming everything. They may not have any collection of music or video at all.
I don't believe it.
You don't think, what's that?
I don't anymore. I used to have all this music, and it's all on Spotify. So
yeah, but he's still, let me ask you, do you have a hard drive in your system?
Oh yeah. No, I have a lot of, I have all this stuff locally too.
Yeah.
You know, so, all my photos and stuff are also here locally, but they're backed up to Dropbox.
See, I'm getting close to what he's talking about.
Yeah.
But I still have a lot of music that's on a hard drive.
I just don't believe that person actually exists. I think there's plenty of people who say they live that. Like if you could live that way, you could live with a Chromebook, right?
Mm-hmm.
I don't know too many people that the Chromebook is their only device, right?
Yeah.
I mean, their only device. In fact, you know, the interesting thing is all the millennials, all the young people with their silly Snapchats, which, you know,
I like go how you nowhere, pluralize right? it.
Yeah.
The Snapchats and the Twitters.
Because I'm around a lot of them, because I, you know, got a pretty large extended family on my wife's side. And man, I tell you, every single one of them got their phone, but they all got their laptops.
Right.
Because they're not going to.
But they may not be saving a lot of files on it.
Yeah, but they're going to, you know, if you have a laptop, that means you need local storage, right? I just don't believe.
To actually run the system, of course.
Yeah. So I just don't believe that there's such a thing. I think they're lying, frankly. I don't think it exists.
All right. Okay. Final. Any final words, Gordon, on this hard drive?
So, I think it's awesome because, you know, hey, if this is, you know, $534 now, get down to $400 for 10 terabytes. It's like, that's pretty nice. You know, things keep going, right? They keep going. So I will never have a system, I think, without a hard drive.
So I would tend to agree for myself. But we'll see. We don't know the future. The future is unwritten. We'll find out later.
Yeah.